Okay, we need to talk about this. LinkedIn for UX designers. Yeah, whether you are a UX design student, product design student, or you just recently graduated, at some point in your design career or design journey, you might wonder whether you need to use LinkedIn to help find you a UX design internship or your first full-time job. In this video, I'll go over my first-hand experience with LinkedIn and show you some examples of how to use it. Let's go. Good morning, everyone. My name is Justine, and I'm a designer working in Silicon Valley. I'm sure you know what LinkedIn is, right? Yeah, it's fairly a complicated quantum mechanics concept that links a external force in to a vectorized eigenvalue. No, just kidding. LinkedIn is a platform, it's a network for professionals. Think Facebook for people who work in a company, or just a professional Facebook. Theoretically speaking, by getting yourself into the network, it should help you find your favorite UX design internship or your first product UX design full-time job. If you consider using it as a UX design student or a new grad, this video should help give you some clarity because I'm going to answer the following three questions. Question number one, does it work? Does it actually work? Is it legitimate? Does it actually help designers find jobs and internships? Number two, what do you look out for on LinkedIn? How do you search? Who do you search for? Number three, how do you network? What do you say? What do you put in the message? Does this sound good? Are you ready? Let's dive right in. So question number one, does it work for finding UX design internships? UX design full-time jobs? Does it work differently depending on whether it's an internship or full-time job? Well, speaking from past experience, short answer, yes, because it kinda got me one internship and one full-time job. Actually, my first full-time job. But long answer, well, kind of. Let me tell you what happened for that internship and my first full-time job. So for the internship, it was my Zynga internship back in spring 2017. So if you look at the message thread on LinkedIn, it quickly directed to the email communication. Hey, I got to the email stage because of LinkedIn, so I should give LinkedIn some credit, right? Or no. Anyhow, that's how I got my Zynga internship conversation started with the company. And next will be DoorDash, my first full-time job. It was back in 2019 and I was messaging the hiring manager directly. After a few exchanges, we moved the conversations to email as well. I will do a separate video document that more detailed end-to-end process of how I got my first full-time job, my first product design full-time job in Silicon Valley. And if you're interested, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so that you don't miss that video when it comes out. So back to the subject, does LinkedIn work? Does it help design students or new grads like you and me got a design internship or a full-time job? Yes, it did work. I got one internship and one full-time job, my first full-time job, directly or indirectly through LinkedIn. Full disclosure though, before I got my first internship, the Zynga one in 2017, I did not believe in LinkedIn at all. Like, at all. I'm still quite skeptical, even today. I don't know if it's luck or it actually works, because there is a catch. Like everything, there's always a catch. Which is, 98% of the time, LinkedIn did not work. If you juxtapose how many messages I sent on LinkedIn and how many offers I got through it, you will get a comparison like this. Conclusion, LinkedIn works to some extent sometimes. You need to have hope and keep sending messages. If you have the patience and faith, then it's a great time to talk about question number two. What do you look out for on LinkedIn? How do you search? Who to search for when you are on the platform? Whenever you apply to a job post, whether it's an internship or it's a full-time job, the automated response that you get is not what you want. You want to talk to a real person, right?
Welcome to Bank of America. This call may be recorded.
Talk to a customer representative. It's the same thing here. So after you applied, you can totally go on LinkedIn to reach out to a recruiter to follow up your application. Say you apply to a Google UX design internship, then you can search Google Recruiter, and then you can hit people. Then you will see about 81K recruiters at Google, and then you can scroll around. But then the next question is, who is the one you're looking for? Which leads to the next point, the different types of recruiters that you have. So there are commonly four types of recruiters that you might see often: university recruiter, technical recruiter, general recruiter, and design recruiters. So the first type, university recruiters, are basically recruiters for internships. They will handle applications for interns. So if you look, university recruiter at Google, that might be something you want to look for if you apply for an internship. And technical recruiters are basically the recruiters that are responsible for hiring engineers, software engineers, hardware engineers, the technical people. Since we're designers, technical recruiters typically don't help us much. Next will be generic recruiters. So they typically don't have any modifier in front of the recruiters. They will just say, recruiter at Google, recruiter at Google, recruiter at Google. So you have technically no idea what they do except that they are recruiters. If you can find the recruiters who will receive or review your application, those are the recruiters that you'll be eyeing for. The last type, design recruiters. As UX design, this community is growing bigger and bigger, and the industry starts to realize the importance of UX design or design in general. There will be recruiters that are handling design applicants specifically. Google, I don't know, let's do a search. Google design recruiter. Ta-da! Oh, there are somebody. So Lauren, UX design recruiter at Google. It's from Seattle. UX design recruiter, UX design recruiter. Great, we are being represented. Or you can search design recruiters in general. You will see, like for example, Slack, a company that cares about design, they will have recruiter dedicated for the design team, for the design organization. Or Facebook, they have that. Flare, Facebook, Chime, Airbnb, of course. So yeah, that summarized the four types of recruiters that you might see often on LinkedIn. So recruiters are the people you typically want to reach out to follow up with your applications, to make sure that they got your application, that they are reviewing it, or if any updates from them, they finish hiring but the post is still up, so they can give you some relatively quick update on that if they actually respond to you. You can also search for hiring managers, design manager, to follow up your application or just to ask if they have any openings in the company. Any post that you see on the company website or LinkedIn or Indeed, any kind of job searching website, they tend to be not conclusive. There might not be such a role, but they might have headcount in general, so they can maybe allocate one of the headcounts to this role that doesn't exist yet, as long as you can make the case. Well, what's the catch? The catch is you might not know who the hiring manager is. Generally speaking, I tend to reach out to design managers as a title or design lead because their titles, their ladders, the levels are higher in the company. They tend to have more information. They might know more or more likely to know if the company has headcount for designers or design interns. Or at least if a design manager on this team is not hiring, they might have knowledge of maybe the other team in the company is hiring, so they can point you to reach out to another team. Once you find the people or the right people to speak with, whether it's for following up your applications or to just reach out and see if they have any openings, any new opportunities, then you might want to know the answer to question number 3. What do you say? What do you put in the message? What should the intro message be like? How should you phrase it? There's no magic formula for this, but to me, the basic rules are keep it simple, cut to the point, and kind of formal. I said kind of formal because you don't want to sound like a machine or a robot, because we are human. We want to communicate like humans. I have written messages in various form and with various amount of information, but basically it comes down to the following. For a message that you send to a recruiter, introduce who you are, what have you been up to, what have you done in the past, tell them that you're interested in the position, and then follow up on your application specifically. And you can also tag on another line asking who you can reach out to if they are not the right person to talk to. For hiring managers, they're basically the same thing. You introduce who you are, what have you been up to, what have you done, you're interested in a position or new opportunity, and then you ask if they are hiring, and if they are, what are they looking for specifically. So here are some of the ones that I have sent for internships. They are not very long, maybe 2 paragraphs max. Here's the one that I sent to the Zynga recruiter for the internship in spring 2017. This is the message that got me my 4th UX design internship. Nothing too complicated, right? And this is the one for DoorDash, my first ever product design full-time job. This one is even more extreme, very minimal. I think the first message was actually from the request message, the one that you can attach to when you send a network request. Yeah, seriously, nothing complicated, no magic, because what ends up happening is the hiring manager will go through your LinkedIn profile, spend 6 seconds looking at it. If you seem legit, then you're in. A tip I can give you is maybe you want to send multiple messages or the same message in different ways multiple times. I would personally send 3 times. If they don't respond after 3, then it's probably a dead end. They probably don't care, or they probably don't want to move forward. There's no guarantee you can get a response even if you send it 3 times. And personally, I'm not a big fan of this, and in terms of not responding, because I feel like at least you can say, sorry, we're not going to move forward, or we already finished the hiring. Just give us some reason, give a proper response, right? If you message me, I would definitely give you a proper response. I think that's just basic human decency. So to recap, LinkedIn, it works for designers to some extent. You can use it to follow up your applications or to reach out for new opportunities, including the ones that are not public on a job post. Lastly, you don't need to write an essay to succeed. A simple message can just do the trick, assuming your profile is solid and legit, of course. If you would like to see a video on setting up a designer LinkedIn profile, let me know in the comment section down below. LinkedIn itself is not a guaranteed win. Even the premium version, actually, I'm not sure because I never bought it. For my Zynga internship and my DoorDash full-time job, I was using the free version. LinkedIn is not so much of a black box. After using it for 6 years, I think I figured that out. So see what you're looking for and feel free to rewind to the 3 questions if you need to. That's all I have for today. Thank you guys for watching. If you find this video useful and insightful, please go ahead and destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm. If you want to see more UX design videos like this, also consider smash the subscribe button as well. Doing so will tremendously help the channel and motivate me to produce more high quality content down the road. Have fun following your passion and keep designing a better future. See you on the next video. Tschüss!